Dear students, today we will discuss about partial derivative. So far we have discussed about differentiation with only one variables, and we also find its application to find maxima and minimum value. So today we will discuss yet another very important topic, partial derivative, and this particular topic has a huge application in chemistry because this is used widely, because in chemistry our properties, they are functions of more than one variable. So when we have a function of more than one variable, then we take the help of partial derivatives. So let us first learn what this means, partial derivative. Now so far we have done derivative of functions with only one variables, like f of x is equal to x cube plus x square plus 6x or sin x log x e raised to the power 4x plus 3. So all these functions, they contain only one variable x. Similarly, it can be f of y cube plus 3y cos y. So these functions, they contain only one variable e raised to the power 3y plus 4. But sometimes what we have a function of more than one variables, like it is denoted by f of xy. Suppose this is the function x square plus y square plus 2xy. Then in this case we take the help of partial derivative. So the derivative of these functions which contain only one variable, they are denoted by dy dx, as it is a function of x. So this will be denoted by dy dy. That means we use the symbol dy dx. But in case of partial derivative, we take the help of curl. So it is denoted by curly f by curly x. That means if this is a function xy, curly f xy by curly x means we have to take derivative with respect to x only. We will assume or we will consider y to be constant. So as this function has two variables x and y, so for such type of functions which contains more than one variable, we take the help of partial derivative, which is denoted by curl. Curly by curly x means the derivative of this function with respect to x. Now we will consider other variables as constant. Similarly, curly y of f of xy will be equal to derivative with respect to y only, and we will consider x to be constant. So that is the basic fundamental while doing derivative of these functions. So first of all, when we have to use partial derivative, when we have a function which contains more than one variable. So variable means when we change its value, the value of function changes. Now the derivative at a time, it is done with respect to only one function, so we take help of partial derivative. So we have assumed this to be a function of x and y. So this function can be like this. So I will solve some problems related to these in our next slides. So when we have to do its derivative, we have to do with respect to x separately and with respect to y separately. And when we do with respect to x, we will assume y to be constant. This is very important. And when we have to do the derivative with respect to y, we will consider x to be constant. So that is a basic fundamental while doing the derivative of these type of functions. And all the rules of derivative are same. All other rules of derivatives, they apply here. So the rules are same. The only thing is that when we have to do differentiation with respect to one variable, then all other variables, they are considered as constants, and derivative of constant is zero. So we will do when we will do some examples, then you will learn. So that is how we do their derivative. So this is called partial derivative, and normal derivative is denoted by dy dx एक्स दिस इज डिनोटेड बाई करली एक्स, दैट मीन्स वी हैव टू टेक डेरीवेटिव विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स. करली वाई मीन्स वी हैव टू टेक डेरीवेटिव विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ओनली वाई एंड ऑल अदर वेरिएबल्स दे विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज कॉन्स्टेंट्स एंड द रूल्स विल रिमेन सेम. ऑल अदर रूल्स ऑफ डेरीवेटिव दे विल अप्लाई हेयर. नाउ विद दिस बैकग्राउंड लेट अस ट्राई टू सॉल्व सम प्रॉब्लम. सो द फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम इज वी हैव ए फंक्शन z is equal to x square plus xy plus y square. We have to find curly z by curly x and curly z by curly y, means partial derivative with respect to x and partial derivative with respect to y. First let us find curly z by curly x is equal to curly by curly x of x square plus xy plus y square. So it is curly by curly x x square प्लस करली वाई ऑफ एक्स वाई प्लस करली वाई सॉरी करली वाई करली एक्स सॉरी करली एक्स ऑफ वाई स्क्वेयर. नाउ एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू व्हेन वी हैव टू डू डेरिवेटिव विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स वी विल कंसीडर वाई टू बी कॉन्स्टेंट. नाउ व्हाइल डूइंग डेरिवेटिव विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स y is considered constant. Now we know that the derivative of constant is 0, so let us apply. Now other rules are same as I have said. So derivative of x square will be 2x plus, now y will be considered as a constant, so it can keep out of integration differentiation. Y curly x of x plus, now y is constant, so its derivative is 0 because we are doing derivative with respect to x. Now we will consider y to be constant, so which gives 2x plus derivative of x is 1, 2x plus y. So that is its derivative with respect to x. So curly z by curly x is equal to 2x plus y. Similarly, we can find curly z by curly y. Now we will consider x constant. Is equal to curly y of x square plus xy plus y square is equal to curly y of x square plus curly y of xy plus curly y of y square. Now while doing this is most important part, while doing derivative with respect to y, we will consider x to be constant. So the rules remain same here. If we have to do derivative with respect to x, then y is considered constant. If we have to do derivative with respect to y, then x is considered constant. Now x is constant, so its derivative is 0, so it becomes 0 plus x will come out of this differentiation. X curly y of y plus derivative of y square is 2y. Now derivative of y is 1, so it becomes x plus 2y. So that is your answer. So curly z by curly y is equal to x plus 2y. So that is how you do partial derivative. I once again repeat, the rules are same. You have seen we have used the same formulas to find derivative. The only thing is that when we have to do derivative with one variable, all other variables they will be considered constant. Now here we had only two variables, x and y. When we were doing differentiation with respect to x, we have considered y to be constant. And when we have done derivative with respect to y, we have considered x to be constant. Now let us do one more problem. So it is also quite easy. U is equal to log x square plus y square upon xy. We have to find curly u by curly x and curly u by curly y. The one way is you can directly start differentiation from here, or the another thing is you can also simplify. So you can do by your choice. Now u is equal to, now we will apply first this formula, log m by n. This we have already done, is equal to log m minus log n, and log m cross n is log m plus log n. So first apply log m by n, it becomes log x square plus y square minus log x y. So we have used, I have used this formula log m by n. Now I can further split it. So it can be written as u is equal to log x square plus y square minus log x minus log y, because we have a negative sign. So that is the function. This function can be written like this. Now it have become little bit easier. Now first let us find curly u by curly x. So curly u by curly x is equal to curly y curly x of log x square plus y square minus log x minus log y. So as I have said, when I will do derivative with respect to x, y will be considered constant. So it is will be given by now log of x f of x. So log f of x, its derivative is 1 by f of x and f dash x, derivative of f x. So this is the formula. So first it is curly y curly x. I will write log x square plus y square minus curly y curly x of log x minus curly y curly x of log y. Now it is 1 upon x square plus y square plus curly y curly x into curly y curly x of x square plus y square minus log of x is 1 by x, y is constant, so its derivative is 0. So it becomes 1 upon x square plus y square. So derivative of x square plus y square, y is constant, its derivative is 0. Derivative of x square is 2x. So it will be 2x upon x square plus y square minus 1 by x. So it can be solved as x into x square plus y square. So it is 2x square minus x square minus y square. So it becomes x square minus y square upon x into x square plus y square. So 2x square minus x square is x square minus y square. So that is the answer. Curly u by curly x is x square minus y square divided by x into x square plus y square. Similarly, we can find curly by curly u by curly y. Now let us see, let us do it. Now these relations are same, so I will erase them. So please try to remember this. I always try to write so that you don't get confused. Otherwise there is no need to write. You should be able to remember these relations. So these are used again and again. So we have also discussed log in detail, where I discussed with you. So that's why I discussed everything with you, so that you don't get confused. Now just from your part, you have to do little bit of practice, only then you will be able to learn. Okay, now we have to find curly u by curly y. So curly y curly y of what is our function? U is log of x square plus y square minus log x minus log y. Now it is equal to curly y of log x square plus y square minus curly y of log x minus curly y of log y. Now derivative of log x is 0, because x will be considered as constant. So its derivative will be 1 upon x square plus y square into curly y of x square plus y square minus log of y is 1 by y. Its derivative is 0. Now derivative of x square will be 0 with respect to y, because x will be considered as constant. Derivative of y square will be 2y. So it becomes 2y upon x square plus y square minus 1 upon y. So upon solving, y into x square plus y square, it is 2y square minus x square minus y square. So 2y square minus y square is y square. It is given y square minus x square upon y x square plus y square. So that is your answer. So curly u by curly y is y square minus x square, y square minus x square divided by वाई इंटू एक्स स्क्वेयर प्लस वाई स्क्वेयर, वेयर एज कर्ली यू बाई कर्ली एक्स वाज एक्स स्क्वेयर माइनस वाई स्क्वेयर डिवाइडेड बाई एक्स इंटू एक्स स्क्वेयर प्लस वाई स्क्वेयर. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इट इज़ क्वाइट ईजी. ऑल द फॉर्मूलाज आर एग्जैक्टली सेम सिमिलर टू द सिंपल डेरीवेटिव. द ओनली थिंग इज वैन वी हैव टू डू डेरीवेटिव विद वन वेरिएबल, वी विल कंसिडर ऑल अदर वेरिएबल्स एज कॉन्स्टेंट. वी हैव टू कंसिडर दैम एज कॉन्स्टेंट. सो दैट इज द बेसिक फंडामेंटल दैट आई एम रिपीटिंग अगेन एंड अगेन एंड अगेन. वाइल डूइंग डेरीवेटिव विद रिस्पेक्ट टू वन वेरिएबल, कंसिडर ऑल अदर वेरिएबल्स एज कॉन्स्टेंट. सो प्लीज try to remember this basic rule. All other rules are simple and they are quite easy. So that was your answer. Now let us see. Okay, now we have one more question. So z is equal to xy upon x plus y, we have to find curly z by curly x. So let us first find curly z by curly x is equal to curly by curly x means partial derivative xy upon x plus y. Once again we will apply same rule, quotient rule. As I have said, rules are same, but only difference is we have to consider y as constant. Okay, now we have to find partial derivative of this function with respect to x. As I have said you, when we do partial derivative with respect to x, y will be considered as constant. Now this y can be taken out of this derivative, so it will become y into curly y curly x of x upon x plus y. So it is y as it is. So we will apply the quotient rule, x plus y whole square x plus y into curly by curly x of x minus x curly by curly x of x plus y. So it is equal to y as it is x plus y whole square. So derivative of x is 1, so it remains x plus y, and minus x into derivative of x is 1, derivative of y is 0, so minus x. So this gets cancelled, so y into y is y square, so it is y square upon x plus y whole square. So that is your answer. Curly z by curly x is y square upon x plus y whole square. Now let us similarly try to find curly z by curly y is equal to curly by curly y of xy upon x plus y. Now x is constant, so we can keep it as out of differentiation. X curly by curly y of y upon x plus y. Now apply the again quotient rule, which gives x as it is x plus y whole square. So x plus y as it is, derivative of y is 1, curly y of y minus y as it is, derivative of curly y of x plus y. So it becomes x into x plus y whole square. So x plus y derivative of y is 1 minus y into derivative of x plus y is again 1, derivative of x is 0, derivative of y is 1, so minus y. This y gets cancelled, so we get x square upon x plus y whole square. So that was your curly z by curly x. This is your curly z by curly y. So rules are same. The only thing is that when we have to do derivative with respect to one variable, all the other variables they will be considered as constant. So that is how you do partial derivative. And please believe me, this is very important in physical chemistry, especially thermodynamics. When you will do thermodynamics or other derivations, so you highly use this concept, partial derivative. So please learn it carefully and do practice. So that was all for today about partial derivative. So please do practice at your home. I once again repeat, this is very important, because once you start thermodynamics, it highly use this concept of partial derivative, because in chemistry our one property is a function of so many variables. So that's why we usually use these partial derivatives. So thank you once again. Please don't forget to subscribe and share with your friends. Thank you very much.